All right, guys, what's up? Today I'm gonna be doing something that I meant to do a few days ago, but I just did not get around to it. I've been not really busy, just haven't really been motivated all that much. I'm sorry. But anyway, today I'm gonna be doing a review on Dragon Ball Super Broly. I'm a big Dragon Ball fan. If you guys have watched my channel or any of my older videos, you should know that. But anyway, this is gonna be a spoiler review, by the way. At first, I'll just tell you what I thought about it and what I thought they could have done better, what I thought they did amazing, and so on and so forth. So what I thought about the movie as a whole. I think I'm gonna give this movie an 8.5 out of 10. I think the story could have been a little bit more fleshed out if they had a little bit more time, but the movie was only an hour and a half long. So there's not really much you can do in an hour and a half, so I completely understand that. But as far as Broly himself, like the actual character, this movie was obviously all about him. Goku, Vegeta, everybody else, their characters have already been fleshed out, and we already know what they are, what they do, and what their personalities are like, and they just kind of just built on that in this story. So Broly is kind of like, he's kind of like Tarzan. He just kind of gives me that Tarzan vibe where he just don't really know what's going on. He's been isolated with his father on this planet called Vampa his entire life, and he don't really know. He didn't even know what a candy bar was in the movie. He looked at it and he about ate the whole damn wrapper and everything. Like he didn't know. He didn't know what water was. He didn't know anything. And his only friend that he's ever had is a big monster that was on the planet. And the monster was named Ba, and that he named the monster after the sound effect that the monster used to make. And he is just a light-hearted, kind-hearted Saiyan, and it actually made you feel for the character and feel for him. Now, he had more latent ability than any other Saiyan in the history of any Saiyan. Like, he is the legendary Super Saiyan. They kind of state that in the movie, but they don't at the same time. They said he may be the legendary Super Saiyan, but I mean, come on. If they say maybe, that pretty much says he is. So I really, really, really liked the character of Broly. I would give his character a 9 out of 10. I wish he talked a little bit more. That's the only thing I wish he would have done. Like when they started fighting and stuff, he never talked. He was a legit caveman at that point. All he did was scream and scream and scream and scream. Now, not that there's anything really wrong with that because Goku and Vegeta don't really talk all that much when they fight either, but you know, I wish he still would have spoke a little bit more. Now, Paragus, his father, he was a good character in this movie too. You kind of felt for him a little bit, but you also thought he was an asshole because he had a ring around Broly's neck, and every single time Broly got a little aggravated or agitated, he would press this button and an electric shock would go through Broly's body, hurting him and calming him down. Kind of like you would do for a dog that goes too far past his fence or something. Now let me get to, let's see, the fighting. I'm just gonna skip the whole part, the first part of the movie. The first part of the movie, it was just a flashback. It was good, it was necessary, it made you feel more in tune with the characters and Goku's dad and Goku's mom. There was a really, really sad moment when they were sending Goku away. It was kind of like a Superman-esque type deal, but you know, it made me feel more in tune with Goku's character and Vegeta's character, and I just think they did really good as far as character development in this movie. Now, Frieza was coming to planet Earth to get the Dragon Balls because he wanted to make a wish, and his wish was to be 5 centimeters taller. Kind of stupid, but it was funny. And Bulma's wish was to be 5 years younger, and they both said only five because it would be too obvious of a change if anything else or anything more. Now, the animation in this movie was amazing. I really want to go. I'm probably going to go back and watch it, whether it's by myself or with somebody else. I don't really know. I really, really, really liked the fighting in this movie. It was really, the music was really good. Now, they had some weird moments when they would be chanting like the characters' names and stuff. That was kind of, I don't know. Sometimes it was epic. Sometimes it was like, okay, what are they doing? Why are they doing this? Stop. Quit the shit. But, you know, in all honesty, the fights were the best part of the movie by far. They definitely spent some time on the fights. They spent hours upon hours upon days upon months just animating those fights. And my favorite fight in the movie was actually Vegeta versus Broly. Now, that was some shit. And there was also a little Easter egg when Vegeta's hair turned green. Now, that was, I don't know what that means. I don't know if that's foreshadowing something in the future or something like that. But pretty much, Broly and Vegeta fought first. And Broly was holding his own a little bit, and then Vegeta went Super Saiyan, and Broly got smacked around, but then he got stronger as they were fighting, and then forced Vegeta to go into his God form, which that's the very first time we've ever seen him go into the Red God form. Which, that was a really nice moment. Everybody in the theater was going crazy over that, and it was really, it was a really beautiful scene, because everything in the background was all white and snowy, and then you just see him and he's all fiery and red, and colors just stood out a lot. And he punched Broly through like 1800 mountains or some shit, and pretty much after that punch right there, everybody thought that he was done for, that Broly was done. His dad was like, "All right, Broly, let's get back on the damn ship. You ain't shit. Come on, let's get back up on the ship." But then after that, Broly kind of went apeshit, and then Paragus started to realize, oh shit, he's about to lose his mind, let me grab my remote and shock his ass. But Chi-Lai, kind of forgot to mention her, but she's kind of a big part of the movie, but she's kind of the love interest for Broly, if you want to call her that, I don't know. All I know is she was a really interesting character. She kind of reminded me of a Bulma, but she was green with white hair. But she was nice in the movie. She added a nice touch, and she feels really bad for Broly throughout the entire movie. She's just kind of the sympathetic. She kind of like looks at Broly through our eyes, if that makes sense, as the audience's eyes. Like, oh, his father's controlling him. His father's doing this. He needs to get him out of this situation. She stole the remote from Paragus and crushed it. So after that, Paragus was like, oh shit, I don't have my remote. Broly loses his mind. His eyes turn yellow. And Vegeta, I think it was probably a final flash or something, put him in the ocean. And then Broly just kind of rises up out of the ocean, screaming his head off. And yeah, that's when Goku and Vegeta were like, oh shit, what the fuck did we just do? We're kind of fucked now. This motherfucker right here is the shit. And I don't know what we just awoke. But in that part of the movie, that's when you knew that shit was about to get real. Now, Vegeta came up after him and tried to punch him as hard as he possibly could in the face. But Broly was just sitting there snarling at the punch. Then he punches Vegeta back. And they go fight for about 10 seconds, and that's when Goku jumps up and he's like, am I going to get my turn? So that's when that fight starts. Like I said, my favorite fight was Vegeta and Broly, but this fight had some interesting animation to it. There was about 25 to 30 seconds during the fight where you were doing a first-person camera of Broly fighting Goku. Now, that shit was really cool. I didn't even notice that until about 10 seconds into the animation that's what was happening, but that was really interesting. I really liked that. I hope they do some more of that in the future. That was really, really, really cool. Goku gets his ass beat in base form. He goes Super Saiyan, gets his ass beat. Then he goes God form. and he binds Broly to where he cannot move. And while Broly cannot move, he's like, we've had a lot of enemies that have came to Earth over the years, but I don't feel like you're one of them. Don't let them control you. You don't have to fight me if you don't want to fight me. Now, Broly, like I said, he does not talk, but at the beginning of the movie and at the very end of the movie, he does not talk. So all he did to respond to that was get pissed off and punch Goku in the face. And then he binds Goku, punches him in the face again. Then Goku body slams him. And then after that, Broly kind of just takes over and beats the absolute shit out of Goku. I don't think I've ever seen Goku get beat up this bad in any movie. Maybe since Jiren. I think he got beat the shit out of by Jiren in the series, but God, as far as movies go, this motherfucker right here, he got beat the shit out of. Like, I felt bad for him. He was making some noises that shit I make when I wake up out of bed, my back hurting. Like, he was making some really, really gnarly noises. He was getting slung up against mountains, breaking his face, and then he got slung like 300 feet and then hit the ground. And then I guess Piccolo just randomly came out of nowhere in this movie and he was like, Goku, do you need help? He said, I would help you, Goku, but I think I'd get in the way. And then Goku was like, yeah, he's strong. We may need you later on. So don't just stand by and we may need you. So after that, Goku kind of stands up and then he starts to try to transform. And this part was really interesting because while he was transforming, he tapped into Ultra Instinct. And he only did it for like half a second, 1 second. His hair turned silver. I don't know if the audience really noticed, but I noticed that his hair did turn silver and his eyes turned silver. I don't know if that was him tapping into Ultra Instinct. I was kind of hoping that he was going to, and then no, he just goes blue. And he really holds his own well against Broly after that. He actually beats him until it seems that Broly's at his limit again. And then this is when Frieza was like, well, it seems like he's at his limit again. And Paragus was like, yeah, I guess we can call this a fight. And Frieza was like, well, I'm not really sure. And then there's a 5-second flashback to when Frieza killed Krillin on planet Namek and Goku went Super Saiyan for the first time. So Frieza had this bright idea that, what happens if I kill Broly's father? How would he react? So he says, well, I have an idea. He turns around, shoots a laser beam through Paragus's heart. He's dead. And then he turns around. This mother clears his throat. He goes, then he goes, Broly, look, your father got killed by a stray energy blast. He pretty much lied to him and said that Broly killed his father, which in all honesty, Frieza did. Broly loses his shit at this point. Now this is at the point of no return, officially. Broly goes Super Saiyan. His pupils are gone. He is beyond rage mode at this point. And there's literally nothing you can do to stop this man at this point. There's nothing you can do. It plays really, really epic music. And it was weird because a lot of the time I was rooting for Broly in this movie. I don't know if it's because of the sympathetic part or just the fact that he's just badass and he's just like this 10-foot-tall monster when he gets going and he just destroys everything in his path and he just can't control it. But after that, Vegeta's like, well, Kakarot, there's no way in hell that you're going to be able to beat him by yourself. And then they do a Gallic Gun / Kamehameha wave. And that shit don't really do anything to Broly. He just kind of punches that shit. And, yeah. So Goku flies Broly over to Frieza and says, have fun, Frieza. And then they instant transmission straight to Piccolo. And Piccolo, long story short, they get taught the fusion dance. Vegeta refused to do it at first, and then Goku kind of reminded him that, hey, the Earth's on the line, Bulma could die, Bulla could die, Trunks could die. And yeah, that's when Vegeta's like, okay, hurry up and teach me this damn thing. He was embarrassed to do this little dance, the fusion dance, but they eventually got it. They failed two times. He turned into the fat Gogeta, and then the skinny Gogeta. And then they finally got it. And there was a little funny scene to where he was trying to come up with his name. And he was like, what should my name be? Gokuja. No, how about Gogeta? And then they instant transmission back to Broly. And long story short, there was literally no competition. Gogeta slapped the hell out of Broly. Broly eventually transforms into his legendary Super Saiyan state. And this is when he's like 10 foot tall, so he's big as hell, terrifying, green hair. And then Gogeta goes Super Saiyan Blue, and there's not really a competition after that. He charges up a Kamehameha Wave, or a Kamehameha Blast, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I just hate saying that word, because it just sounds like too much. But charges that up, and he was gonna kill Broly. Like, he really was going to flat out kill this man with no remorse. But Chi-Lai got a hold of the Dragon Balls before Frieza could, or behind Frieza's back pretty much, and wished for Broly to be saved and to be sent back to the planet that he grew up on. So that's pretty much the movie right there. Goku instant transmissions over to Broly's planet, and he's like, hey, there's some things that I want to teach you. I would love if we could spar in the future. And he also brought some little capsules so that they'll be able to survive. He brought them a shelter capsule, some food capsules, and some water capsules so that they will be able to survive on that planet if they want to. Even though they may just move, is what they said. But Goku said that he would be able to find them whenever, as long as they're not too far away. And at the very end, Chi-Lai was like, hey, what do we call you? He's like, my name is Goku, but Broly, call me Kakarot. Credits roll. So that's pretty much it. I really, really enjoyed this movie. It was the best theater experience I think I've personally ever had. It was just crazy to see this show that I've watched growing up since I was a kid, and just seeing it on the big screen, and it was just awesome. It had a good place in my heart, this show does, and it's just something when I'm going through stuff, I can just sit down and watch it, and everything in the world is just okay. And I'm sure all you guys have shows like that, so you can probably understand what I mean when I say that. I'm sorry this dragged out a little bit longer than it probably should have, but sounded like I was fucking crying right there. It's dragged out longer than it should have. But I hope you enjoyed. If you didn't watch the movie, definitely go watch it. If you do like Dragon Ball. Even if you don't and you just like action and you like comedy, the movie is really funny. There was a lot of times when I laughed. There was times where it was really sad and it was really funny and it was just really epic. So I recommend this movie really to anybody. Even if you don't like Dragon Ball like that. I mean, I'm a nerd, so I like it, and I grew up on it. But I'm going to stop rambling now. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. More videos on their way. Don't really know what videos I'm going to make, but we're going to find out. So I'll see you guys later. And like I said, enjoy the rest of your day. And see ya.
Yeah, I'd rather be a lover than a fighter. Cause all my life I've been fighting. Never felt a feeling of comfort. All this time I've been hiding. And I never